Hey guys, welcome back to the B stream. We have the deciders match between Hotform versus Jackie Chan. And they are pretty known for bringing Reggie decks, so this is going to be a fun series for sure.
Exactly.
Exactly. I'm not sure what they're playing, but I'm pretty sure that Jackie Chan is going to bring some kind of Yogg. And Hotform is also really known for his Yogg, like his tempo mates and so on.
They're banning right now.
Okay. I know that Jerry Chan is playing his Insult Paladin, and he's also bringing some kind of a Reggie Shaman, and most likely Yogg Mage. I'm not 100% sure about the decks.
I just know that Jackie Chan is playing Paladin.
Okay, we get the bans here. Hotform banned Jackie Chan's Paladin, Insult Paladin, so Jackie Chan got Druid, Mage, and Shaman. And Jackie Chan banned Hotform's Rogue. I know that Hotform was playing Yogg in his Rogue.
Mm-hmm.
Do you like that? You're like the Rogue expert?
I don't like Yogg and Rogue. Since you never get to play it, right? You always die before.
You die to six.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. You play a lot of spells in Rogue and it's a board clear?
Yeah, you play a lot of spells, but you never get to play Yogg most of the times.
Okay. But yeah, Jackie Chan banned Hotform's Rogue, so he got Mage, Warlock, and Warrior left. So yeah, it's like it's really off meta lines ups and classes compared to what normal people bring. So I think this is going to be a fun series for sure.
It's kind of weird that he didn't bring Shaman.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of weird. Yeah, and Jackie Chan didn't bring Warrior. It's like the four best classes right now is Druid, Shaman, Warrior, Warlock for sure.
Mm-hmm.
So it's nice to see that he brings some new decks.
We need to join the game. Do I have to watch Jackie? I think so.
Yeah, I'm watching Hotform. But this is a really, really important game because the winner is getting to top 8 and guarantees $1,250, I'm pretty sure. Mm. So that's a lot of on the line. Do you know who won this group? I think it was Rado.
I actually don't know.
I think it was Rado.
I don't watch the games.
Yeah, it was Rado. Okay, now we just wait for them to pick the class. And it's last hero standing, for those who just tuned in. But who do you think is the favorite? Line of ice. Also, Hotform is not bringing Yogg Druid. Like, Yogg Druid has been insane in Seed Story. Yogg Druid and Su has been the two most dominant classes or decks, I think.
Yeah, Yogg Druid is also pretty strong. I think Hotform is a bit favorite because he has Tempo Mage against his Druid and Shaman.
And Shaman. Do you think Tempo Mage is favorite against Shaman?
Well, it kind of comes down what kind of Shaman it is, right?
Yeah. Okay. We see Hotform play his Su and Jackie Chan. Gonna play his Shaman. And I know Jackie Chan is playing some kind of wacky Shaman with Earth Elemental. He's also playing Face the Shambler.
Oh.
So, I don't know if it's good or not. But because if you like revive the Face the Shambler, you get a 1-1. So it's not good to put. What's the name of the card that revives? I never play Conceit Shaman.
Something with air.
Yes. Yeah, because it has really, really bad synergy together with the Shambler. But I guess it's another face there, so it's fine. Okay. Hotform has a really nice curve.
Job's done.
Do you coin out the Pitta here? And just curve. Oh, flame him. It's nice.
Yeah, that's much better.
But would you have coin out the Pitta if you didn't?
Probably.
Yeah, and then just curve
passing
out.
Turn with Zoo kind of feels bad.
Yeah. Okay. So now you play Doomsayer here for sure.
Mm-hmm. I like it.
Like a lockdown this next turn. So this is actually a really, really good start for Jackie Chan because Jackie Chan just wants to get to the late game so he can play all his big minions, faceless, and just win. Oh, too late. That would have been insane if you took that earlier.
Does he run two Doomsayers?
I'm not sure. I know some people don't like Doomsayers in the Shaman because when they gonna joust with the heal, they don't wanna get the Doomsayer because it's only 2 mana. But we see that Jackie Chan's playing it. I think he plays 2 since he played 1, so he can still get value from it later. You can also, some shamans also playing Manatide Totem.
Yeah, I think they all play two.
Two Manatide Totem? Yeah. Okay. But who's favorite in this matchup?
I think Zhu is, because you have so many board clears as shaman.
Yeah.
You have like two Lightning Storms and two Elemental Destructions.
So shaman is favorite. Lightning Storm feels really bad here. You just play just the 7/7. Next turn you can Lavish Shock Lightning Storm or something, maybe.
Just Lightning Storm. And then Lavish Shock.
Yeah, sure, of course. It's just really scary to keep up the juggler. Oh, we got the Forbidden Ritual.
This feels awkward.
Yeah. Do you like Pitline to Pio? Pio's not even good on this board. Forbidden Ritual is just really, really dangerous to any board clears. So I'm not sure what's the best line here. It's like, if you get a PO, you could... No, you can't create it like MSPO.
I would probably just Argus.
Argus and go... Do you even trade in the totem? It doesn't do anything in this shaman, this, does it?
Yeah, it doesn't help you that much, but you probably clear it. Otherwise, it would heal the 7/7 backup. Yeah.
Okay, Hot Farm is thinking about this.
Probably taunt up both white walkers.
Yeah, it's really, really good against Lightning Storm. Okay, decides to go with the aim game boss instead.
Okay.
Also good against Lightning Storm. Ancestral Spirit.
So maybe you do Lava Shock first.
Yeah, on the aim game boss and then Lava Storm. And then Lightning Storm. Yeah, then you get a bulk. And then there will be one up. And then you just go... It's still like... You need to roll high on the Voidwalkers.
Yeah.
It's not really a good Lightning Storm sport. I think you would well have Elemental Destruction here. Well, not that's even that good. I think it was actually a really good play playing the in-game boss. It's really awkward.
Maybe your Spirit?
Your Spirit and just trade? Yeah, I wouldn't mind that. It's just... You're gonna lose a lot of damage because the Zhu will just go face. They will not fight for the board.
Yeah, that's true. You could also Lava Shock the Knife Juggler first.
Okay, he decides to go full. Yeah, you could Lava Shock the Knife Juggler and make the Ancestral Spirit. Okay. Let's roll high, boys. Okay. Decent.
That rocks.
But his next turn is really awkward because he can't play Sylvanas because of Overload.
Yeah. He's actually playing Rag as well. It's kind of crazy, isn't it?
It's a really, really greedy shaman list. If he also plays the Faceless Shambler. What did he cut?
Well, I don't know.
Okay.
Probably he cut like Anzon, Siok, and so on.
Yeah.
All the late game cards.
So this has to be a Voidwalker, right? There's no reason.
Oh, I can see it. Oh.
Oh, he can choose between Angry Trick and Voidwalker or Blood Imps.
Yeah, then it's Voidwalker.
And then do you play Forbidden Ritual, since you just see a board clear? Or just play Forbidden Ritual?
Yeah, probably. Yeah. Your other options are not great, right?
No, Elena. Doesn't feel good to take 7 damage though. Okay, decides to go for the Voidwalker. This is really, really good for Jackie-chan. Now you can...
I don't think you do that.
No, you Ancestral Spirits and Lava Shock live Flame Imp. I think you totem up first, right?
Does it matter how you do it?
It's like if you get a Spell Power Totem, you could kill the 1/3 and go 7 damage phase.
Oh. I think you want to kill the flame.
Yeah,
you?
I think so. Because it's not a rage for the shaman. The way the shaman wins is just having
shoots.
Yeah,
control.
Exactly. So I guess you touch him up first, no matter what. And then you can see it from there. Did you get the new shaman?
No, I actually didn't.
Me neither.
I don't care so much about CEO.
I didn't get the paladin armor. Okay, decides to save the lava shark. It also makes sense since he got elemental destruction in hand.
Mm-hmm.
So I actually like that. Because he knows he will get overloaded later.
Yeah, you still have a lot of HP, so it's kind of fun.
Yeah. It's actually way better than killing the flame imp. Okay. Created Alchemax. On what? On the totem? An Argus. Okay, decides to tap first.
My shield for Argus. Yeah. Oh, wow.
He's gonna get punished. But there was not really any way he could play around it. You never trade here.
Yeah.
Okay, elemental destruction plus 5/5 taunt. Seems juicy.
Seems pretty over.
I haven't even tried this Shaman deck. Have you tried to play it?
I played it in the old times with like the late game.
Yeah? Cards,
with like Anzons and so on.
But what is the reason that it got so powerful in old cards? Because you never saw it before. It's like because Big Game Hunter is gone. You can play your Earth Elemental and so on.
Yeah. And
because there's no new cards in the deck, right? Like before old cards.
Actually, that's true. It's probably just because of the PGH nerf.
Yeah, I think so. Okay. And next turn he can lever shock Sylvanas. He's in really, really good spot. Do you want a Doomguard here? Nah, you don't. Or do you just play like the Dark Shara and Forbidden Ritual?
You don't have good options. I like this.
Yeah. Trill of damage.
Lava Shock Sylvanas seems fine.
Yeah. And then how do you trade into the 5/5? Do you trade the 7/7 into the 5/5?
Yeah, I would trade to 7/7, yeah.
And just Lava Shock a 1/1 and go face for 5 damage.
Yep.
Seems good. There's no reason to trade the 5/5 into a 1/1. No, I think
it plays around Direwolf, but yeah. You don't have to play around Direwolf here, do you?
No, I don't think so.
In the end, he still has to sacrifice 3 minions.
Yeah, he also sets up lethal if he goes face, if nothing dies.
Oh, is he thinking about elemental? No, that doesn't make sense, right?
Yeah, it's really, really greedy. Like roll 4 on your 5/5 and roll 5 on the councilman? No, I don't think so. But is he maybe scared of dying? Is there any way he can die?
I don't think so.
He needs like P.O. Leroy P.O. That's not even lethal. You need at least 3 cards to get a
He probably knows the list as well, right?
Yeah.
Said he runs 2 Doomguards.
Okay, he wants the P.O. now. Gets a Soulfire. You play the Soulfire, hope you don't discard the Doomguard.
Hmm? Does that make sense? Ooh.
Still a really, really tough position for the Soul player.
Oh wow, that's interesting. And it's good.
Yes, really interesting that he didn't do it on the 5/5.
Wouldn't he have 1 more 1/1 if he did it on the 5/5?
Yes. Well, this is lethal, right?
Oh.
No. So.
You probably trade with Direwolf Rag. No need to take a risk, right? Actually, maybe you go face.
I think you go face, yeah. It's also more likely that you hit a minion.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you go face, yeah, for sure. You play Sylvanas and go face. Because even if you trade and it misses, you're in the same position. Okay, face rack.
Okay.
6. Leroy is not enough. He can't stay alive. Like Kyo, the Direwolf, Tridental, Sylvanas. And hope it steals the Direwolf?
Maybe you play Imgengmos and Gormok. But you have to play Gormok next to Imgengmos, so he can't steal.
Yeah, he can't trade in with Sylvanas. Yeah, this is probably the winning line, and just go face and hope. Yeah, I like that.
I don't think trading into Sylvanas
no,
will help you.
Yeah, you can never win if you do that. Yeah, like him game best, go mock and go face. Because there's no damage from hand Chaggy-chan can do. There's no lightning bolt, there's no...
Oh wow.
He does the trade instead.
Okay. So he's probably hoping that it hits game boss.
Yes. This is lethal.
Oh, actually it's lethal, yeah.
Okay. So Hot Farm got Mage and Voyeur. What counters? What counter the Shaman deck normally?
The Shaman deck.
I guess normal midrange Shaman counter because of Hex.
Yeah. It's kind of hard actually.
Also that you're not used to play against this deck, which can
yeah.
help you out. Okay, he goes with the Tempo Mage. I'm not sure, it would be way better for Hot Farmer if he's playing Polymorph in the deck, but I don't think he does.
No, he does not.
Okay, it's only a few people. I know Sixo likes Polymorph in his Tempo Mage.
He probably plays one.
Yeah, he plays one only.
Hot Farmer is playing Acolytes.
Oh, really? Oh,
Forgotten Torches.
Oh, yeah, I remember that deck. He hit rank 1 Legion in NA at some point with it. Yeah, and 2 Torches, and then you just want to cycle your deck and burst them down.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a really, really nice hand for Hot Farmer. Do you keep the... Yeah, you keep the Elemental Destruction? Or just the Lightning Storm?
I don't know if I would keep anything. He keeps Elemental Destruction.
Here you see the faceless.
Probably Farsight is fine, but
yeah.
Oh, that's an interesting card.
Yeah, it's
the
really
faceless.
Yeah, it's really bad with Ancestral Spirit, but it's good against the 7/7, I guess. I tried to play it in Reno Lock with the Mountain Giant, but I'm not sure if it's good or bad in the Shaman deck. Okay, you just toot him up. There's no way you play Elemental Destruction into this.
Nah, there's no reason. Just Farsight.
Yeah. The board is not that threatening yet.
Not scary enough.
Also, if Hot Farm is playing like Flamebreaker next turn, it's a really, really good Elemental Destruction. If Hot Farm is playing a Temple Flamebreaker or something, then the Elemental Destruction is really, really good next turn.
Yep.
If he had it.
Has to be Farsight.
So what is the best card you can get from Farsight?
Oh, wow.
A big taunt to kill it with Ancestral Spirit.
Normally I would say Spirit is pretty good to get out of Farsight.
Yeah.
Maybe it turned here.
But he's really thinking about it. Okay, he goes for the far side. Right.
How's the 7/8 taunt called again from Shaman?
Earth Elemental?
Yeah, exactly. That one is probably the best one.
Yeah.
Rag for 5 mana is also not too bad.
Can make a Kobe off it really fast. It's not that good against Tempo Mage though. Oh, this, the water Elemental is really, really awkward.
Yeah, it doesn't die to Elemental Destruction.
Do you just play a 1/1 Faceless Shambler? you can't copy your open as minion, you can only copy your own minions.
Hmm.
actually. This is awkward.
Has to be hero power, right? Otherwise, you just pass your turn if your element is fractional.
Yeah.
Like, you want to help play element is fractional.
Same with Lava Shock next turn. Okay. Now we just pray the Hot Form play his entire hand.
I don't think he will.
No, I think he got enough board. I don't think he needs to commit anymore.
He might Frostbolt face, maybe even Frostbolt again. To get the damage in with some of them.
It's one spell power. It makes sense. There's nothing you want to clear with the Frostbolt in a way. He decides to use one.
I can see it keeping so as well.
Is there any reason to clear that minion? Wouldn't it be better to ping face?
Yeah, actually, it's probably better to clear. It's probably better to ping face.
Yeah, so the only reason is that it's more likely that he maybe get a spell power totem with Lightning Storm.
Maybe he was trying to play around Lightning Storm and something else.
Yeah. Okay, now he just makes the board again. If you Lightning Storm, you have 5 mana next turn. But it's risky.
You have 2 Lightning Storm, right?
Yeah, I think so, because you're too much overload next turn. Yeah, he goes for the Lightning Storm. And hope he rolls high.
And
got him! 2-2 on the others and 3 on that one. Classic. Okay, Water Elemental. I guess the ping the 1-1 is fine here.
Yeah. Rekka?
Oh. He's go for the winning line, I guess. He could just Hex Totem up. Okay, check a chance and he's on point. Oh, how much damage is this?
This is actually pretty close though. Like,
imagine if Hotform has been pinging face way more, this would almost have been lethal.
Yeah, actually if he would have pinged the face instead of the 1-1.
Yeah, he would have lethal now. Oh.
Do you maybe do that even?
Do you heal?
Yeah, I think you heal.
Yeah, you can't do so at this point. He has only 1 card.
Yeah, exactly.
I think if Hotform has like pinging more face this game, he would have won. Instead of pinging all those tokens.
He would have only gotten 1 or 2 more damage in two, right?
Yeah.
Maybe it would have been enough. It's kind of close.
Okay, full heal.
I actually like the Shaman deck.
It also seems fun to play. Okay, do you clear off? You have to clear off the board now.
Then you hope for York, right? If you clear.
Yeah. So just ping the 4-1 and Roaring Touch the Ragnarush. Seems good. Because that's how much damage does he does have 9. Yeah, there's nothing he can top deck. Oh, he goes with the Frostbolt. And keep the 4-1 alive?
Okay.
I don't like that.
I don't like that as well. I guess he takes 4 damage and saves 3 damage for himself.
It's working out really well for him now with that top deck. So maybe it's correct, because now he can kill both of the minions.
Okay.
Do you play Thing from Below, double Ancestral Spirit?
I don't think you have to double Spirit. 1 Spirit is probably enough, okay. So I guess we fast it first.
Yeah, seems good. Oh, he goes for it.
Oh, he wants to get more damage. Yeah, that's actually much better, right?
Yeah, it's more damage on board. I don't mind it. No, that was not what Hotform was looking for. He will looking for some card draw.
Yeah. Jock is kind of card draw and spot clear, so he probably wanted that.
I wanted Jock. Jock is everything. I have no time for games. Yeah, and you just clear.
I like spiriting Sylvanas.
Sylvanas is also really, really good against Jock if you place it, because then you steal the spells.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, he goes face to set up lethal.
And GG.
Okay.
Jackie Chan 2-0 up.
Shaman has also been performing really good, those Conceit Shamans, or what you call them. Like, Froden went 6-0 with Buck Creeper.
Yeah, he was wrecking it.
It's nice to see those fun decks, because there's not that many on ladder.
Yeah, I think I saw a lot the last days again. After Froden doing well with it.
Yeah.
So what does he have left?
Hot Pump got Voya left. I think it's some kind of Dragon Wire. I'm not sure.
Is Dragon Wire good against it?
Oh, it's Kafun Voya.
Oh, Kafun. Oh, wow. Kafun is probably not great, right?
No. What's the plan? Do you go for Cheek or do you try... It's like, there's so many threats in Jackie Chan's decks.
Yeah, I don't think you can win in Fatigue, right?
No. It's like Ragnaros. You have to beat 3 Ragnaros, maybe. But it's also really hard to race them, because Kefunwa is not that good at racing. Also, if he plays Doomcaller, Jackie Chan can just hex the Kefun, and then he can't revive it.
Yeah, that's also a problem. I think you have to...
Oh, even Frost Giant. Oh, that's the reason he plays Faceless Shambler, maybe? But you don't totem him that much, do you?
No, you don't totem. You only totem him in the beginning sometimes, right?
Oh, he plays Doomcaller. Maybe he has to, like, shield slam his own Kefun in this game to revive it. So he can't hex it. It depends if he plays the Bran Emperor combo.
He probably does.
Yeah. If he does, he has, like, to shield slam his own Kefun so it doesn't get hexed. But we will see.
I think if you run Doomcaller, you're kind of forced to play Imperial and Bran as well.
Yeah, it's different. I know, like, Stan Sivka is just only playing Emperor and no Doomcaller. It's different from player to player. Some was just playing only Doomcaller.
Do you maybe Hero Power here? I think you're Farsight, Otto.
Yeah.
Okay.
He really wants to play the Giant. Or get the Giant cheap.
I don't like the Frost Giant, because I don't think you hero pose that often.
No.
Maybe hero power sink from below. You could also...
Do you trade first to get another 1-1? Or do you rather want the Torn Totem? Or do you want to...
I think you want to get the taunt or heal. Taunt would be nice.
Yeah.
So I would say you totem first and maybe Stormcrack.
Yeah, I like that. It's like, if he keeps making totems, because Kefunwa has a really, really hard time racing the Shaman. They don't have that much damage.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't have that many minions to Fred's win. Okay, he decides to trade first.
Okay. So he's probably keeping the coin for later on for combos.
Yeah. This is a nice clear. Yeah, this time it goes face. I like going face here.
Hotform is trying to pressure, but I don't think it will be so easy.
No, because Chai-Chan got 3 ways to heal.
Yeah.
Healing Wave and the Shaman Legendary. I don't know the name of it.
Halazir?
That's right. Okay. This is a good Lightning Storm. You're not going to get any good Lightning Storm against Kefun Voya.
So. I like it.
Oh, Justica. Is there any... No, you can't fatigue this game. You can't go to fatigue. There's too many threats.
Yeah, I don't think it will help.
Okay. Stormcrack is nice here.
Yeah, I like it.
And just totem up.
Especially with the frost giant, you just want to totem up for a while.
Yeah, as much as you can. Yeah, it doesn't feel good to be Hotform in this spot, because he knows it's going to be hard to win this game.
Wow.
Oh, he wants to block the turn 7, because it's normally turn 7 that's good for Kefunvoya. They got the Shield Bear and the Vekla.
Okay. I guess you just play Helazeal. Because I don't think you need to heal out of Helazeal in this matchup.
No. I don't mind it. You can also just play Earth Elemental.
Doesn't he still have to execute?
Yes, and Shield Slams.
Yeah, so I like Helazeal a bit more. He really wants to go with Earth Element, but
I guess he got a lot of minions he can use Ancestral Spirit on later. What's it called?
Yeah, it's called Spirit, yeah.
So don't think he necessarily wants to copy the Earth Elemental. Maybe goes Coin.
Oh, does he want to go Coin Seed? How's it called again? Giant?
The Frost Giant. Giant. Then he's not overloaded for next turn.
Okay.
Well, no removal. So get your slam and hope.
You might even slam your own Acolyte.
I was thinking that as well. Because it doesn't matter. Yeah, I would also slap my own. Or maybe not since you top deck the Ghoul. This is guaranteed clear.
Yeah, I actually like this more. Gets a guaranteed clear. Because in the other way, you're kind of forced to top deck, execute, or shield slam.
Exactly. So you start using your Farsight now? Oh, Priestess Champ.
Ooh, that's pretty good.
Yeah. I think he wants like the whole, like a really, really big combo.
You could even use it now with 7-7.
Yeah, with the 7-7. Yeah, I guess I don't mind that. New card, PogChamp?
PogChamp.
You could use Brain, Disciple of Kefun and kill one of them. It's just...
And play Acolyte?
No, you can't play your Brain because you need the Brain with the combo, right?
Oh.
Now he can...
For which combo?
With like Kefun, when he wants to revive his Kefun.
Oh, I see.
If he plays Emperor, then he can like Brain Doomcaller to get two Kefuns.
Yeah. But I think you have to do that, right?
Yeah, you have to.
You could have also just played Acolyte and hope for Brawl, maybe?
Yeah.
And play Katu Chosen.
Yeah, because you really don't care about the damage.
Yeah.
It's not the way the Shaman wins. It's just buying, having board. So... You can just kill the Brain and play another. You don't want to totem here if you're playing another minion because of Brawl. There's no way you hex the Acolyte.
Do you maybe just play the 7-7? Oh, that's a good totem.
You have to kill the Brain here.
Yeah, definitely kill the Brain.
Do you like the totem?
No, I don't like the totem.
Because of Brawl?
Not only because of Brawl, also because he could get the 1-1, maybe, and then he might be able to draw Maud or Sand Collide. Like
trade into the 7-8 with Execute and then get another card. Yeah, I see what you do. See what I mean?
But also because of Brawl.
It seems like you're gonna play the Kefun Chosen and then Brawl. No. No, just Amma. Yeah.
Yeah. I think you don't even want to play anything anymore.
No.
From the Shaman side. Just Far side, maybe, for now.
But do you kill the Acheline? Or do you just... You have already seen two Slams, so you have seen one Ghoul. So maybe you can just go face.
It's kind of tempting to use Lightning Storm, but...
Yeah, it is.
Hmm.
It's also a little risky if it's... only hits two.
What if you trade, like... the Acolyte and the Cartoon Chosen with your 7 attack creatures and then Lightning Storm?
Trading what, you say?
Trade these bows in.
Oh, and then Lightning Storm?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess I don't mind it because you really don't care about the face damage, right? And also Brawl gets even worse since you only have 3 minions on board. Oh, it starts with the Lightning Storm. Oh.
Yeah, that's why I didn't like it much.
Now he has to go face with one of them. Or with both of them. Okay, just the full face. Now we got a little punished.
Okay, execute. That's pretty good.
And then he can also clear the 7-7. With the bow axe. And then play the Wiggler.
Yeah, I like it. Doesn't even look that bad anymore for her.
No, it doesn't actually.
Oh, no, maybe it does.
Two 7-8s. So you just play the Earth Elemental and Ancestral Spirit. You don't? Do you play another 7-7?
I think you can, but do you really have to? You don't really have to, but... How big is this cartoon again? It was 16-16, right?
Yeah. It's okay. Getting... He's really thinking about it. There's no way you hex here because you have to save it for the Kefun.
I think you just play this... Earth Elemental and Spirit.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how much more late game he has in his deck.
You still have Ragnaros and Sylvanas.
And one more Spirit.
Yeah, one more Spirit.
I think both plays are fine. It really comes down how much more late game he has. I don't think just Rag and Spirit will be enough. Sylvanas doesn't help in this matchup, does it?
No. It's annoying for the Boyer to deal with. If they can't clear it because they can't play a Kefun into it.
Yeah.
But it's not that huge. So what do you even do here? You have to Brawl this turn, but how do you do it best?
Maybe you just Brawl and hope your
one of your first six
yeah, wins.
And then hit execute? Yeah.
I don't like trading into it.
No.
Okay, now he Brawls.
Well, this guarantee is clear. So... But I'm not sure if it's the winning line.
Well, just play Hazazel.
Yeah,
you don't need
like
to
it.
Heal.
How many cards do they have? 8 and 12. Okay. So right now, Jackie Chan is winning the late game. Well, Sylvana's really, really bad against Harrison Jones.
Do you maybe even just pass?
Yeah, I think you just totem him up and do nothing. You already have heal in hand. There's no reason to play the Sylvanas.
Yeah.
It's a value game right now, so... I would definitely just totem him up.
Hmm, I like it. You need to keep this hex as well.
Yeah, for the Kifun. But... Hotform still got 2 shield bears left.
Hmm?
Right? He still have 2 shield bears.
Yeah.
So, he still have some.
But I don't think it helps.
No.
Does it?
No. Not really.
Hmm. Yeah, you can't really do anything here. Sylvanas has potential to get more value if he plays one more minion.
Yeah.
And he is kind of forced to play one more minion.
Yeah, to win the game. Maybe you even play the Doomcaller next turn as hot form. Oh, he plays the Sylvanas.
Okay.
I'm not sure if I like it.
Because yeah,
there's
like
no way you're
one.
Dying. You even have heal in hand. Yeah, because now this 6-6 is awkward.
Yep.
Yeah, he can hex that.
Yep, it's fine.
But let's say he didn't top deck a hex. Would be really, really awkward.
I didn't like Sylvanas play. Because now his turns are awkward, right?
Yeah, I didn't like it at all. Yeah, that was actually no reason to do it. Since you have heal in hand, you just want to draw out the game and get the value from it. Mm, you play the Doomcaller here as hot form?
Mm.
I think you do, because there's no way that he's not gonna hex your Kifun.
Yeah.
I think I would play the Doomcaller.
I think I would have played it so as well. Well, just play. Do you play Rag? Maybe you wait.
Yeah.
Play around Brawl.
Let's see the cards again. So Hot Farm has 5 cards left and Chucky Chan got 9.
Does Gohl help? Not really.
Not really. You can kill totems all day, but I'm not sure if that's gonna make you win the game.
Value! Well, he has a lot of HP, but it doesn't really help.
He will power pass. Resident Sleeper.
Resident Sleeper.
But right now, Chucky Chan is winning. It's like, Hot Form has to do anything, do something. I guess Hot Form is hoping that he can revive his Kifun with the Doomcaller.
Yeah, he's hoping for it, but he's probably just hoping that Jackie Chan doesn't get his second hex.
Yeah.
Well, hero power pass.
He has to rope.
To
like rope, he will power pass. Rope, he will power pass. Okay. Echoline. You really don't want to draw any cards.
I think you have to play it so. Like, is there a way you win this in fatigue?
I think actually the Kifunwa could have killed or plays 2 Frost Giants.
Hmm.
Okay. But I guess you just end turn, right? There's no way. 4-7?
If you play Frost Giant now, you can play Rag next turn, but I don't think you have to. Just pass seems fine. Like, Sylvana is kind of forced to do something, right? Yeah.
Did Hot Farm play his Sylvana yet?
I don't think so, no.
Okay. Okay, I think Chaka Chan will go to rope and then end turn. Oh, he goes with the rag.
Is there a reason to rag?
Only if he's scared for fatigue. Oh, the Kefun. But you shield slam the 8-8 first, then Kefun next turn?
Maybe you brawl.
Yeah, you could also brawl.
Wait, how big is a cartoon?
It's 16-16.
Okay.
He could also save it and then like... if it goes for fatigue and then just play it. So you can't do the heal, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, that might be something.
But still, long way to fatigue.
So you don't play the cartoon then?
Yeah, but I'm not sure if that's the line to win the game.
I think it's actually the line.
To win, and then like brawl, play your Kefun, and hope he dies to fatigue.
Then you shield slam now, right?
Yeah. And then just hope you get a lot of armor. Okay, brawls. Yeah, because you need the brawl if you want to kill all the threats, I think.
Yeah. Oh wow, that was close. So maybe you should play Doomcaller soon.
Yeah. Like, if Hotform is playing Emperor, he can maybe play Kefun, shield slam his own Kefun, and then revive it.
Oh, that's interesting.
Because then he gets... That's maybe the line. I'm not sure if he plays Emperor, because it's not every Kefun warrior who plays Emperor with Doomcaller. But think... Maybe?
Maybe.
Because then he also gets list in the fatigue.
Oh wow. I guess you do it. On the Frost Giant.
Yeah, that's no brawls.
You could also play the thing from below, right? Wait, how big is the weapon?
Yeah, you don't play thing from below.
You actually don't play it. Just Frost Giant Spirit seems fine.
Yep.
I'm not sure if he has more late game.
No, me neither. I'm almost out of cards. Okay, Shield Bear.
Shield Bear seems fine.
Yeah, we just play it here. So let's see if the last card is Emperor or what it is.
That's not useful.
But how do you clear the 6-6 here? Do you play Ailments of Destruction? Like trade the 1-1 into a 6-6? Or do you just play a 8-8? You really don't want to waste your minions to deal with it.
I think your Element of Destruction.
Yeah.
I don't think Element of Destruction will be useful.
You go face with the 1-1, right? Because it's... Oh no, it's 5-6. Yeah, this is counting.
Do you have to Lava Shock? I don't think so.
No. You don't care about the overload next turn.
You could Doomsayer.
Yeah, Doomsayer is nice. I would also Doomsayer.
Yes, that's it.
He's thinking about the Lava Shock. But he can also Lava Shock next turn if he wants to remove the overload.
Lava Shock face, good play.
That's a mod. Oh, he plays Emperor. Okay. That's the reason that he saves the Shield Slam then.
Okay.
Okay, maybe he can win now actually, because if he revives the Kefun, it's a lot of damage.
He also takes less fatigue like this, since he gets a cartoon again in the stack. So I think he's actually winning.
You think? That's fine. He can just hex it, right? Because when he revives it.
Yeah, but still.
He He still needs to kill the 7-9 and the Emperor.
It just seems like he has no more late game in his deck. He has probably another Healing Wave. What else does he have left?
Healing Wave. It's really hard to figure out Chagachan's decks.
Yeah.
Since they are so wacky.
I don't know, I would have played Frost Giant a bit earlier.
Yeah, I guess he gets doing that. But he thought it would be Fatigue no matter what.
Hmm?
He thought it would go to Fatigue no matter what, but there was no reason not to play it.
Yeah. Now he plays it. Also this thing from below, okay.
He knows there's no more brawls.
Time to pew pew pew.
You don't hit with the weapon first? To the 5-5? Because then you can guarantee go 5 face damage with the Emperor. Yeah, it does that.
Yeah, I actually like it.
Oh, that's nice. Then shield time your own Kefun. Also, if Chagachan has played his first giant earlier, he was forcing Hot Form to using Shield Slam on it.
Was he?
Nah, maybe. It's like, how would he deal with it?
Actually, maybe that's true. Maybe you would even force him to Katu.
Okay, so you're faceless here and go.
Face
seems good. I like face.
Face seems good, yeah.
And then Hot Form will play the 7-9 and then Kefun again. This is actually a sick game. I'm not sure who's favorite on normally. I think the Shaman is favorite. Normally. Oh, he trades.
Does he even have minions left? If he doesn't have minions left, then it only heals for 7. Oh, another faceless.
Oh, he can face this, the Kefun.
Oh, wow.
Kefun will... Oh, he wins then. Because then he can faceless Hex. Right. Yeah, I think Chagachan is winning this game. Unless he dies to Fatigue before he can kill him.
Maybe this Doomcaller can do things.
I think he should have gone face with the 8-8 last turn instead of trading into the 5-5. There's no reason to trade. I think the damage is really relevant right now.
Yeah. Because Sovara has to trade anyways, right?
Yeah, but now he has to trade because the Kefun is coming next turn.
Mm-hmm.
So do you... I guess you trade your 8-4 into the 7 now and use Lava Shark?
Okay.
I don't like this because he's gonna play Kefun anyway, so
yeah.
I would because the 8-8 would he got healing towards him. So. So next turn gonna be faceless Hex.
Maybe you don't even play Cartoon.
Oh, and just wait for the fatigue? Yeah, because he knows he got faceless left and he knows there's one more Hex.
Maybe you just play Ghoul?
No, you can't do that because you can't kill the Frost Giant because it's gonna get healed by the healing torture.
Yeah, I guess you're forced to play Cthulhu.
Oh yeah. Oh yes, you can because the Ghoul can trade into the Frost Giant, maybe.
But Hot Form knows that the last card is faceless, right?
Yeah, and he knows he got one more Hex. K, Okay, Chagatian needs to roll that Torn Totem now.
Wait, why would you play Acolyte?
No, there's no way to play Acolyte.
That doesn't make sense, right?
If you wanna die faster. Well, this guarantees that he can kill the Frost Giant. Because even if he gets a Torn Totem, he can trade the 3-3 into the Torn Totem. And then Acolyte into the Frost Giant and hit it with the Gohowl.
But you die to fatigue so much faster now.
Yeah.
Maybe it doesn't matter, so.
Maybe he already calculated it.
Yeah.
In his head. You go face with the 8-4 here every time.
Hmm?
There's no reason to trade here, right?
Ooh. I don't think trading is too bad. Because you can't Elemental Destruction next turn, right? Since you have to play Faceless Hex.
Yeah, but let's say that Hot Farm's plan is to raid. So Chagatian, because Hot Farm is not gonna play his Kefun, right? He's rating that to Chagatian's losing a lot of fatigue damage and then play the Kefun.
Yeah.
So I would have went face with the Frost Giant for sure. I think the 8 damage was really relevant.
How much fatigue does Hot Farm take? 5 already. Oh wow. Okay. This game is over, right?
Yeah. Also, we got 9 life on board.
Hero power pass. Time to sleep more. Well, don't have to sleep for too long anymore.
Okay, good one. Hero power pass. But Chagatian is roping. Oh, it's not. Okay.
He should faceless his own totem, just for some BM.
But maybe if Hot Farm didn't draw any card this game, he would actually maybe have won the game. Because he killed all the minions from Chagatian.
Yeah, that's actually true.
If he just didn't draw any cards, because he got the Justica early. So if he just armor up and kill all the minions Chagatian have.
I actually thought Chagatian has a bit more late game.
Yeah, but he has a lot of late game. 2 Frost Giants, Ragnaros, 7-7, Earth Elementals.
Yeah,
it's a lot. Not sure, it's a really... Oh, how much damage is gonna... One off.
Oh. Well, 3-0.
Oh my
huh?
God. Like, yeah, 3-0. Shaman too good. So, Chagatian is going to top 8.
Oh, really?
With those Rakidex. So congratulations to Chagatian.
Clapper!
Woo! But, yeah, so... This group is over.
Yep. Congrats to Chagatian.
The next group who's gonna be on B stream is Thijs, Oskaka, me, and Ignai.
Oh, good luck to you.
Thank you.
Wreck them all.
But yeah, thanks for tuning in. There will soon be some other games.
Yep. See you guys.